Year-over-year analysis is a way of measuring performance over time. It's used by financial analysts to measure financial performance, and it's used by economic analysts to measure economic performance of different countries. Let's look at an example. Here we have a company that has the number of units sold in Q3 of 2017 and Q3 of 2018. The year-over-year analysis takes the ending number divided by the prior period number minus 1 to get a year-over-year growth rate of 55%. We should point out that year-over-year analysis can be done on any sort of time series. It could be weekly, monthly, or quarterly data that's compared year-over-year. Let's talk about year-over-year and seasonality. It's especially useful for analyzing companies that have a large amount of seasonality or cyclicality. As an example, if the chocolate industry is very seasonal with high sales in December, it is much more useful to compare the sales in December 2017 to the sales in December 2016 versus comparing the sales in January to the sales in December. This is a classic example of where we would use year-over-year analysis. Other common uses of year-over-year analysis for financial analysts include looking at sales revenue, gross margins and cost of goods sold, SG&A expense, EBITDA and EBITDA margins, and the bottom line, net income, as well as earnings per share. Now let's look at economic indicators. Inflation is measured on a year-over-year basis, as well as unemployment rates, interest rates, and gross domestic product, or GDP. Thank you for joining us for this quick tutorial on year-over-year analysis.